should. Should is a modal verb, and we often use it in English conversations to give advice, to recommend something, or even suggest something. It's also used to predict something that is likely to happen and to express an obligation. You see, there are so many ways in which we can use should. We will take a close look at each of these uses and understand the grammar rules to use should correctly. If you are new to this channel, like, subscribe, and click the bell so that you don't miss any of my new English lessons. Let's get started. We always use should with all tenses and subjects. No matter what the subject or tense is, you will always use should. I should. You should. He should. She should. It should. We should. They should. However, you need to remember one thing. You cannot add an S at the end of should, as you do with other verbs. For example, the verb give can become gives, or take becomes takes. But we cannot add S at the end of should. He shoulds work harder. No, that's wrong. He should work harder. That's the correct sentence. Also, after should, we always use the base form of the verb. You never say, you should to go now. That's incorrect. You should go now. That's the correct sentence. Here are two incorrect sentences. Let me know in the comments, what's the mistake in these sentences? You shoulds study seriously. You have a test tomorrow. They should waits for us. Now, let's understand when do we use should in English. The first use of should is to give advice, recommendation, or suggestion. It's used to say, what is the right thing to do? You should watch Ozark on Netflix if you like action web series. You are recommending someone to watch Ozark. It's a great series on Netflix. I loved all the seasons. Some great American slang words. He should see the doctor immediately if he's complaining about chest pain. It's advice. Of course, if someone has prolonged chest pain, they should see a doctor. You should try the new Mexican restaurant on the main street. It's a suggestion. See? How we use should for advice, recommendation, and to suggest something. Why don't you write some sentences for each one of them? I would love to read your comments. The second use of should is to talk about a situation that is likely to happen in the present or near future. Let's look at some examples. Ryan should be at the office by now. Why don't you give him a call? Here you are, predicting that Ryan will be in the office anytime soon. They should have received the email. I sent it in the morning. Again, you are sure that they have received the email. It will be there in their inbox. The third use of should is to express an obligation. He should drive more carefully. Now, you can also use must instead of should. Must is a strong word compared to should. Must makes the sentence sound like a command or an order. So to soften your tone and sound more polite, you can say should instead of must. Everyone must wear a seatbelt in the car. Sounds like an order, doesn't it? Instead, you can say, everyone should wear a seatbelt in the car. It sounds like an instruction and not an order. You should pay your taxes on time to avoid penalty. In all these sentences, you can replace should with must to make the obligation stronger or less polite. The fourth use of should is to express that something was expected to happen in the past, but did not happen. Take a look at this sentence. I should have called Ava this afternoon, but I forgot. Note, in such sentences, we always use should plus have plus past participle form of the verb. Here, called is the past participle of call, something you were to do in the past, that is, call Ava, but you forgot. You should have told the truth when he asked for it. You can use should to say someone hasn't done something that they were supposed to do. In short, they haven't fulfilled an obligation. Such sentences are formed using should plus be plus verb in the ing form. Here are some example sentences. You should be wearing your seatbelt. The person is not wearing one right now. You are asking them to behave sensibly and wear a seatbelt. Enough of excuses. You should be submitting your report by tomorrow morning. Here, the boss is asking you to be responsible and submit the report. If you notice in both the sentences, someone has not fulfilled their obligation. Those were the five uses of should. Now, let's learn how to use shouldn't. The negative of should is should not, and the contracted form is shouldn't. We usually use shouldn't in spoken English, as it sounds more natural in conversations. Shouldn't is used to advise someone not to do something, because it could be bad or wrong to do it. You shouldn't go to the office if you are sick. It's a recommendation not to go to the office because you will be stressed and get more sick. You shouldn't spend your whole salary on that phone. You shouldn't stop practicing English if you want to get fluent faster. All of these sentences are advices or recommendations about not to do something. You can also use the sentence structure think plus should. For instance, look at this sentence. I think you shouldn't go to the party. Do you think this sentence is correct? Think about it for a second. This sentence is incorrect. As a rule, we do not use I think and shouldn't. Instead, we add don't before think and make it negative. I don't think you should go to the party. That's the correct sentence. Keep this in mind. Do not say, I think you shouldn't. Always say, I don't think you should. I hope you got it. And lastly, let's look at how to use should in questions. We use should in questions to seek someone's advice, recommendation, or suggestion. Take a look at this sentence. I should leave now. It's late. It's a positive statement. How can we change it into a question? It's simple. Just change the order of the modal verb should with the subject. Should I leave now? It's late. Should I wear the black dress for the party? Here, I am asking for your advice or recommendation. You can also use question words such as what, when, why, etc. before the modal verb. What should we do now? Why should he lie to me? That's all for today. I hope now you know how to use the modal verb should correctly in English sentences. Practice making sentences with all the uses of should. I will see you soon with one more English lesson. Until then, keep learning keep practicing English. Bye.